What's up? Welcome back or welcome to my channel. If you are new here, before jumping any further into today's video, be sure to click that subscribe button. We are trying to reach 5K. Hopefully by the end of the year, I post videos 3 times a week, so there is always new content to watch. So it would really mean the world to me if you chose to join the family. I've been doing a lot of polls on both my Instagram and my YouTube channel recently, asking you guys what videos you want to see throughout the rest of this year. And I have had an overwhelming request for, you know, continuing making my finance videos, budgeting videos, money talk videos. And I've been pretty open in a lot of my finance and especially my low buy videos about my budget and how I really pride myself on generally pretty much sticking to my budget, which definitely did not happen overnight. I have been somebody who has been learning about budgeting for a really, really long time, and I love kind of reading up on, you know, finances. So I feel like throughout the years I have actually become really, really great though at like defining my budget and sticking to it. And during a pandemic, I feel like having a budget and sticking to your budget is more important than ever. So in today's video, I wanted to share some ways that you can really make sure that you stick to your budget. I was doing the outline for this video and I ended up writing down like 30 different tips, which was way too much for one sit down video. So if you guys would like to see a part 2 where I dive into some of the things that I'm not going to mention in today's video, please let me know by either giving this video a thumbs up or just letting me know in the comments down below. And without further ado, let's just jump right in. I know that this kind of goes without saying, but you actually have to have a way of organizing your budget. It is absolutely useless to simply just say, oh, I'm gonna stick to only spending X amount of dollars a month and just like keeping that number ingrained in your head, because then that's not a budget. You know, you're not really designating how much money is going towards, you know, each category every single month or every single week. And if you just have that number kind of floating around in your head, you're going to get really lenient. And you know, if there's like an extra kind of more frivolous purchase, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna end up purchasing that just because you're like, oh, well, it was just like a, you know, a gauge, like a number that I had in my head. It wasn't really set in stone. But there are so many ways to organize a budget. For me, I prefer the basic Excel spreadsheet format. I'm a very visual person and I like kind of being able to see everything in one place. So I really love making spreadsheets, but there are also so many different apps that you can download, free apps, free resources. Some people even prefer using like the bullet journal method, having a budgeting notebook. It really just comes down to whatever is going to work best for you. And if you guys would like to see how I create my budget Excel spreadsheets, please let me know, and that's an entirely different video that I could make. Break down your budget by month and then by week. I think the more detail you can go into, the better, and the better chance you have of really making sure that you're sticking to your budget. So within an app that you're using or within an Excel spreadsheet, make sure to break down your monthly expenses and then break that up week by week. That way you can kind of predict exactly what you're going to need to spend every single week. And that way you can kind of take a broader look and see, you know, if there's one week that's a little bit lighter expense-wise, maybe that's the week that you treat yourself to a nice meal, or maybe that's the week you finally get yourself that nice sweater that you've been eyeing. This is a big one that I cannot stress enough, and that is to pay yourself first. As soon as I get paid for, you know, a freelancing job, I immediately put a percentage away into my various savings accounts and my investment account. And then whatever is left over, that's what I'm using for my monthly and weekly budget. And I know that obviously depending on, you know, what your paychecks look like, you might not be able to put a crazy percentage away into your savings accounts or your emergency fund, but I promise every little bit helps no matter how small it might seem. Those savings accounts and those emergency funds are going to be invaluable, especially, you know, if you have a surprise purchase that you have to make that wasn't originally in your budget. That way, you know, by having a little bit of extra money tucked away, you'll never have to put anything on a credit card. You'll never have to spend money that you don't have. And it's also just enforcing really good money habits, healthy money habits. Plan out your meals. I cannot stress this enough. I love planning out my meals. I typically try and meal prep when I can, but this is something that truly has saved me so much money over the years, because by planning out my meals and looking at the food that I'm going to need to buy, I'm never going to overpurchase when it comes to my groceries. 9 times out of 10, I'm going to finish everything that I buy, so nothing's really going to be wasted. And also, by always having my meals planned out and always kind of knowing what I'm gonna be cooking for myself that week, I never really play the game of, oh, I don't know what to make, so I'm just going to order in. You know, living in New York City, it definitely can get incredibly expensive, but I really do believe that one of the ways that I'm able to keep my budget so low and like my overall expenses so low is the fact that I really only eat out like a handful of times a month. And also by cooking for yourself, you know exactly what you're putting into your body. So if you're somebody like me who tries to eat as clean as possible, this is just a really helpful tip in general. And kind of going along with that last tip, my next one is to grocery shop online. Now my boyfriend and I started doing this once the pandemic hit, of course, because we were trying to eliminate being in crowded areas like a grocery store. But by doing this, we're literally only ordering exactly what we need. I feel like when you go grocery shopping in person, it can be really tempting to like see all these things out in the aisle and like put more into your cart than what you really need. And I know that a lot of people hesitate to grocery shop online because they think it's going to be crazy expensive. We shop on Amazon Fresh and it's literally the exact same price that it would be if we were shopping in person. But like I said, I feel like we actually end up saving money because we don't pick up those like extra, food items that we really don't need. They just kind of look fun. And they're also probably not the healthiest. So again, it's just another way to stay a little bit healthier. Now, I am not going to sit here and tell you guys to not partake in, social outings and gatherings and adventures. But in order to make sure that you're sticking to your budget, I really do suggest kind of sticking to a set amount that you commit to per month. You know, as much as I would love to like go out for dinner with friends every single night, that's simply just not a sustainable lifestyle financially. And right now, especially given the times, I'm really not going out with friends unless it's for like a socially distanced coffee or something. But back when everything was open, I would typically try and stick to like, two outings with friends per month and then, a couple with my boyfriend as well. And if you're somebody like myself who likes to be super, super social, do some research into like free events happening around your town or outings that you can do that are gonna cost $0. Here in New York City, we're lucky enough to, have so many beautiful parks and, there are street fairs that are free to walk around. So I really think, if you're somebody who doesn't necessarily want to limit themselves to a set number of like outings with friends, then definitely do your research into outings that you can do that are free or relatively, low in cost. Also, if you're invited to an event or an outing that is simply just not in your budget, know that it is completely okay to say no to things. I think that this is definitely a huge reason as to why a lot of people my age actually end up going over their budgets. It's because they're invited to an outing or event and, they feel bad saying no. But I promise you that your friends, if they really are your friends, are going to completely understand if an event or, an outing is just simply not in your budget for that month. Keep an eye out on every single thing that you're subscribed to and cut out anything that isn't absolutely necessary. We're living in such a digital age where there are so many different, digital subscriptions that you can, become a member of. And oftentimes, we subscribe to various websites or apps because we think, oh, it's a deal, it's gonna save me money in the long run. But if you're not using those subscriptions on an extremely consistent basis, I'm talking at least weekly, then it's not worth it. And I'm definitely really proud of myself and happy to be able to say that everything that I'm subscribed to, I truly deem a necessity. I have my Amazon Prime membership, which I absolutely love, and that also, allows us to use Amazon Fresh. I have my Melissa Wood Health subscription, which is how I get, a lot of my workouts, which for me, working out is an essential. I'm subscribed to both Billy and Curology, which are kind of more in the beauty category, but those subscriptions are only every 2 months. And honestly, that's pretty much it. Anything else, any other subscription that I've been offered, I usually just turn down because it's not something that I'm going to be using on a super consistent basis. So 9 times out of 10, it's actually gonna cost me more money because that subscription charge is going to hit my card and I'm not gonna use it for the whole month. I think it's great to be, somewhat strict on yourself when it comes to creating a budget plan and sticking to it. However, if your budget only consists of the things that you absolutely need, and a lot of them are simply just like human necessities, such as rent, groceries, your electricity, and you haven't allotted any money, going towards something fun for yourself, then sticking to a budget is just almost gonna feel like a punishment, and you're gonna be more likely to just want to abandon it altogether. And so when I say this, I don't mean go out and like treat yourself to a designer bag or, spend $300 on a super extravagant meal. But I do think that it's really, really important to treat yourself, at the end of every month to kind of reward yourself for sticking to your budget. So whatever that looks like to you, it could be, again, like a new lipstick you were looking at, or maybe, a dinner at a restaurant that you've really been wanting to try. And that way there is some excitement in your monthly budget. And again, it's just not gonna feel like a punishment. Finally, my last tip for today's video is to sleep on big purchases. This is something that I adopted probably 3 years ago or so, and it's seriously been life-changing. So basically what you'll do is you'll decide what amount of money qualifies as a big purchase. Typically for me, that's anything over like the $300, $400 mark. And it could be different for everybody. You know, for somebody it might be anything over $1,000. For another person it might be anything over $100. It really just kind of depends on your overall income. And so what I really suggest doing is as soon as you kind of think that you want to purchase something bigger, sleep on it for at least a few days. If within 4 to 5 days you're still thinking about that item, then go ahead and purchase it. But if you realize you're not really thinking about it, it pops in your head every now and then, but you kind of decide like, eh, I'm not really crazy about it anymore, just skip it. Because that shows you that it really wasn't meant to be in your life. This will also just help you really filter what is truly going to bring you joy in life, and that way you end up with things that you know you love and you're truly going to use. And so by sleeping on it for a few days, you know, it might be hard because we live in this world where everybody wants things instantly and we want them now. But like I said, if you just take a beat and sleep on it, you really will realize the things that you actually really do need and the things that you could just kind of thought you wanted. And 9 times out of 10, I promise you, you know, if you slept on it for 4 to 5 days and you decide that you really want to go ahead and make that purchase, you really won't regret it. For me, off the top of my head, the first big purchase that comes to mind that I made, you know, within the last few months was my vlog camera. It's literally right here with me. I feel like it's always next to me. But you know, I definitely sat on this for a second because it was a pretty hefty investment. However, I am so glad that I bit the bullet and invested in it because I have used it almost daily and I feel like I've almost made my money back. And you know, I bought this like pretty much right before the pandemic hit. And you know, if I wouldn't have bought this for myself, I wouldn't have had a camera with me in Nashville for like the 5 months that I was there. Meaning I wouldn't have had any content for you guys. But because, you know, me and my boyfriend thought we were only gonna be in Nashville for a couple of weeks, I brought this camera because I was like, oh, you know, it's not gonna take up too much space. And if I have something to film, I can do it. And I ended up being there for 5 months. And so this was literally my saving grace. And I'm so thankful that I ended up purchasing this for myself. Those are all of the tips that I have for you guys in today's video. Like I said, if you would like a part two, let me know by either just giving this video a thumbs up or letting me know in the comments down below. Please subscribe and help me get to 5,000, hopefully by the end of this year. But if not, I'd love to hit it, you know, anytime in the near future. So if you haven't subscribed already, please do so. It would mean the absolute world to me. Follow me on all of my other social media networks. The links are always in the down bar below. Subscribe to my podcast. Check out my Amazon shop. Again, everything is always in the description box. Until my next video, I hope that you guys are staying safe, happy, and healthy. And I will talk to you all very, very soon. Bye.